for the grand entrance. Help me welcome teacher Love Herma Cadion. Lawrence and Ms. Micah Althea Michelle Saga. Performed by Ms. Jihan Katapusan, followed by the invocation to be led by Teacher Julie Arisgado.
Oh, Mga kababayan, ang pambansang awit ng Pilipino.
Praise God. Truly, our God is faithful. So, tonight, let us entrust the event to our God. So, may I request everyone to please put ourselves into His presence. Glory to God. Almighty God, we thank You and praise You for so many reasons. Firstly, thank You for gathering us here safely tonight, in spite of the bad weather. Secondly, thank You that Blessed Zion Academy of Cebu is holding an event like this, which will bring us closer to each other and gather memories to cherish. Thirdly, thank You for the supportive parents, and thank You, Lord, for Your provision to their needs. Thank You for the opportunity to get dressed up and have fun with friends and teachers as we eat, dance, and laugh. Tonight is the first time, or maybe once in a lifetime event, and is a very special evening for all of us. We ask You, Lord, to bless us to have good time, teachers with students, students with their classmates and schoolmates. Bless us to make fun and good memories of this special time. Please keep us safe throughout the activity and give each of us the strength to avoid temptation that would harm our relationship with You. May we be a good role models in how we act, what we say and do, and on how we dance. Don't let any of us to be self-centered, but help us to be always Christ-centered. As we joyously celebrate tonight, the night to remember, we also can't forget that there are some people who are in great distress, pain, and suffering for the loss of their families, friends, and loved ones. We pray for them to get over and move on by Your grace. Give them the strength and courage. May they see the light ahead of them. This is our prayer in Jesus' name. Amen.
Let us remain standing in honor of the Philippine National Anthem to be conducted by Ms. Mary Ashley Villarreal.
Mga kababayan, ang pambansang awit ng Pilipinas.
Tubalang araw na buwan,
tonight's event. Let me start off by introducing myself. I am your host for this evening, Teacher Leona, for some of you who might recognize me, and Miss Leona for the new faces I see here tonight. Now, why are we here tonight? What are we celebrating? Well, tonight is a very special night as we are celebrating the first ever Blessed Zion Academy of Cebu Graduation Ball and Prom Night 2023. And to formally welcome us all, let me call onto the stage our beloved school administrator, Mrs. Leonila Labrador.
Good evening to the BZAC, staff, teachers, and pupils. In behalf of our principal, Dr. Janet D. Birani, who is in Manila right now, it is with pride and honor that I welcome you all tonight to BZAC's first ever graduation ball and prom night 2023 with a theme, A Night to Remember. This is a special night for the teachers, but most especially to the students, as we are celebrating a new milestone in your student life. As a past student myself, I could recall that it was moments like these that added spice to the happy days of our student life. Though I never experienced this momentous event due to some other reasons, yet I was so excited and looking forward for it. For me, it was events like this that solidified friendships, that made bonds stronger with fellow students. With social events like these, we hope that you can forge stronger connections with one another. Not only does this make your academic journey easier, but it makes real life fun and the friendships last. Before we start the main event, once again, welcome everyone to tonight's festivities. I would also like to formally open the dinner buffet. Let us fill our stomachs before we party the night away. Thank you all for coming to the Festivia and enjoy your dinner.
Thank you very much, Mrs. Leonila, for the very, very warm welcome. And as for our beloved school administrator, we all know you guys are starving. So without further ado, we now formally open our buffet dinner. So gentlemen, please allow the ladies to queue up first in an orderly fashion at the back of our dinner buffet over there. So guys, please enjoy your meal. Girls, please line up at the back first, and then the gentlemen will follow. But before that, guys, let us put ourselves in the holy presence of the Lord.
Okay, let's say our graces first. O Lord, we thank you for this very wonderful evening that you have given us. Thank you, O Lord, for the food that has been prepared for us. May this food be blessed so that our physical aspects will be strengthened to ready ourselves for this part two of our program. O Lord, to you alone we bring forth all the glory and thanksgiving. These we pray in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen and amen.
Amen.
And Jomar.
Okay. All right, so...
Teachers, you can line up as well at our dinner buffet at the back. Teachers and staff, please line at the back as well for our dinner, and then followed by our boys. We would also like to remind you that again, once the program has started, we highly discourage you to stand and take food from the buffet. So we suggest you take an extra plate of pika pika on your table so you can snack on it as the program is ongoing. Again, no more standing to take food from the buffet throughout the duration of the program. So you are only allowed to take more food once the program is done. So guys, take a little extra pika pika on your tables so you can snack on it while the program is ongoing. But for now, please enjoy your dinner.
This is the first ever Blessed Zion Academy of Cebu graduation ball and prom night 2023. Before we move on to the next part of the program, let me share with you the importance of tonight's event. This evening highlights three key experiences for everyone here tonight. First, as this is a graduation ball, it highlights the experience of the grade 10 pupils leaving behind primary schooling to become junior high students. Second, it depicts the courage of the grade 9 pupils as they accept and take on what is left behind by their predecessors. And third, as this is a promenade night, it represents the socialization between grades 6, 8, 9, and 10. With that being said, it is time for one of the most awaited performances of the night, the formal social dance for tonight's event, the Cotillion de Honor. With that, may I call on the pupils, grades 6, 8, 9, and 10, to take the dance floor.
Thank you.
A round of applause.
applause, please.
Predecessors. With that, let me call on teacher Joanne Capin for the presentation of the grade 9 and 10 pupils, to be followed by the bequeathing of the key of responsibility by Ms. Giselle Jean Tutor, to which is accepted by Ms. Denise Marie Pakibo. May I request everyone for a moment of silence.
Great. Grade 9, Adam James Hassan. Sophia Pashona and Denise Marie Pakibot. For grade 10, Jonathan Pashona and Giselle Jean O'Tutor.
In behalf of the graduating class of 2022 to 2023, I am turning over this key of responsibility to you, which symbolize the duties and functions laid upon your shoulders as the incoming grade 10 students. Continue to protect the good name of our school, nurture the flame, and keep it burning and strive to achieve honor and fame for our dear alma mater. This key also symbolizes limitless doors you can open. Unlock all the doors which will lead you in a good path and grab every opportunity that comes your way. With this key, we pass on to you the skills to learn, the aptitude to succeed, and the creativity to make a difference. We hope to see all your dreams come true. God bless.
On behalf of the incoming grade 10 students, we wholeheartedly and humbly accept the key responsibility that you have entrusted to us. We will do the best of our ability to set ourselves example worthy of emulation. The legacy that you will leave in our school and in our lives, and the bias to show these responsibilities, we will continue. Because the next time we pass the key, we will definitely remind the next grade 10 student on how you took care and handled everything here in our institution. Thank you very much.
All right, we have witnessed a very special moment tonight of the bequeathing and acceptance of responsibilities. To commemorate this, let us light our candles, starting from the mother candle, which is held by our school administrator, Mrs. Yonila Lavador. This light shall be passed around until everyone has lit their candles. Of the Junior Senior Promenade, and on behalf of our fellow warm-hearted seniors, we humbly hand with honor and glory this candle of learning and the challenges it entails. Junior, receive this candle that unites you with the blazing and unending endeavor towards the quest of knowledge and one's upbringing. The challenge is now yours, right here, right now. This candle shall symbolize the vast responsibility that you now carry in your shoulders, to lead and guide the whole Bizanian community in the acquisition of knowledge and values. Allow this fire never stop burning, not only in mind, but also in heart, as you now craft your own path that will direct you the meaningful destiny of your life, to mark and in the books your own legacy. This candle shall signifies the strong foundation for friendship, dear juniors. As we leave, May you pursue and finish the task, especially the mission of initiating the change that we are about to leave, and put your best efforts in it.
Fellow seniors, as we take another step in the ever-challenging ladder of life and join the exodus to the sea of providence outside our dear old school, let us soar, let us fly, let us reach our dreams and fulfill our journey. May we never forget all the good things we learned here in Blessed Zion Academy of Cebu, and leave and forget all the bad that has happened. Now, we are going to face a much bigger, bolder, and more challenging life as we set foot outside this campus. It is now time to say goodbye. We may be distant physically and for each other for a time, but not for long. The memories in Bizac are always in our hearts and minds. Thank you.
Yeah.
let's give... All right, let's give yourselves a round of applause for that successful review. Again, let's give everyone another round of applause again for that successful review that we have celebrated tonight. Job well done, guys. Now, help me welcome on stage another talented duo, Ms. Jihan Katapusan and Mr. John Patrick Pakibot for a song performance. Thank you.
All right, again, another round of applause for them, guys. That was a very heartwarming serenade for us tonight. Now, their future is definitely bright. And speaking of the future, we have two pupils who will be reading for us their class prophecies. This is where they use their sixth sense to foretell and predict what they think will happen to the class in the far future. So if you're excited, help me welcome onto the stage Ms. Micah Althea Krishnasava and Ms. Giselle Jean Chakor. She will be giving out the class prophecy as a representative of the grade 6 pupils.
Boarding PR113. Last call for passengers boarding PR113. I knew that was my cue. I stood up and picked up my suitcase and presented my ticket to the boarding gates. Good morning, Ms. Saga. Welcome to the Philippine Airlines flight from San Francisco to Manila. I was so happy hearing those words. Yes, I'll be visiting Philippines. I'll be seeing my friends and relatives back home. I have been working as a head nurse in one of the biggest hospitals in California. And I, together with Mama and Papa, I've been living here for 4 years. As I settled down at my business class seat, I was about to start reminiscing when the flight attendants served our first meal. After 18 hours of flying another connected flight to Cebu, I arrived safe and sound. I was so tired that I got home. I laid my back flat to the bed and immediately fell asleep. The next day, I decided to dine in a Michelin star restaurant. It is currently the top of the town. Fast forward, I got a seat and started ordering. I was so impressed how my food presented. It was so delicious. I called the server and asked, "Sir, thank you for this scrumptious meal. Is it okay for me to meet the chef and thank him personally?" "Certainly, ma'am. The chef is also the owner of the restaurant. She'd be pleased to meet you." "Oh, it's a woman?" Few moments passed, I saw the chef walking towards my table. She looked so familiar, but I cannot recognize her. Maybe because of her shift light in your white uniform. But then, she crossed her arm and smiled. "Oh my, it was Shane." "John, it's you." "Yes, it's Chef Shane Tagalog, a very famous Cubana chef in the Philippines. She owns two restaurants here in the Philippines and one in New York." We talked, giggled, and laughed as we reconnected. Time passed and I left the restaurant, heading to an event. I was invited to the Nobel Prize winner, Marcus Joseph Noval, to his book launching and celebration for one of his books being awarded as number one New York Times bestsellers. Joseph became very successful in life. For his love for writing, after the book launch, I then went home. While driving, I cannot help myself but in awe as I shrine my eyes in the city lights of Cebu. When the traffic light turns red, I step on the brakes and turn the radio. Good morning, Southsiders. Today's number one song, Love Struck, from our very own turn K-pop star, Ashley, Mary Ashley Virgo, became one of the famous K-pop star, and sought after model not only in the Philippines and Korea but all around the world. Ash and I never lost communication. I knew all of her heartbreaks, her victories, her falling in love stories. Because of her, I got to have free tickets to concert and backstage VIP passes. Isn't it great to have international artist friend? I continued traversing the road going back home. I then heard a loud bang. It was a vehicular accident just happened right in front of my car. I was not hurt because I stepped on the brakes right on time. Four cars crashed and many were injured. As a nurse, I hardly got out of the car and checked on the injured people. I applied first aid and called for help. Few moments passed, I heard all types of sirens. Ambulance started coming to the accident area, police and fire trucks. I was told to relieve knowing that the patient would be transported to the hospital. Among the crowd, I noticed a man in a different police uniform. Others were giving him a salute. He then walks toward my direction. He looked so familiar. My heart was pounding, which I don't know why. I look at his name on his uniform, my eyes widening. Hi, Mika, how are you? Do you recognize me? It was Police Brigadier General Jander Fuentes. I did not recognize him, since he's taller than me even, more muscles and more. We tried catching up all the years have passed. Not far from us, a man called Dirk, a tall, dark, and smiling man. He is the head of Cebu Fire Department, Liam Neil Jacob Ariston. His team have been called to help freeing the injured. By God's grace, there were only minor injuries. After everything was cleared in the sea, the three of us went to the coffee shop nearby. We talked and laughed. I called Joseph and Shane to join us in catching up over coffee. An hour after, Ashley called me and told me that she just arrived in Cebu from Korea. I also invited her over memories of her coffee and pastry. It was a perfect bonding of all the years we were not able to catch up with each other. Just then, Joseph phone rang. It was a video call from Cyrus, Captain Cyrus Maninho. He became very successful seaman. After traveling in different places and being the ship captain, his expertise helping to build his own company. He owns 5 cargo ships and rents 6 more ships. He then invited us to his place and to have a reunion. Indeed, the reunion was memorable. Cyrus owns a farm and a private beach. Our need was all taken care of, and we do not have to worry about accommodation. because his mansion was huge that each of us could get a room for ourselves. Indeed, the reunion was memorable and a blast. It was so refreshing to see my classmate Ibiza 15 years ago when we were sixth grade. Now, I'm back at California, just smiling and seeing my friends and laughter we shared. I'm hoping for our next reunion. So long, Magnus, until I see you all again. Thank you.
Again, we have up next Ms. Giselle Jean Chotor for her class prophecy. Another round of applause, please.
This is my prophecy. Funny thing about life is you never know when will the twist starts. But here I am, standing in front of you, my fellow schoolmates, telling you how I prophesied the life you will have 10 years from now. I woke up one morning feeling the crave of a hot chocolate of Starbucks. So I raided and hopped in my baby car, which is Rolls Royce. As I was locked in traffic, more moms from different commuters gathered my senses. Oh, there was the collision of two private cars, and there is still no doctor. So me, being a seafarer in a cruise ship for quite a dominable time, rendered me to know some first aids. So I immediately get out of my car and saw the intersection. Four injured passengers and two drivers. I work on my knowledge on how to handle such. As I was done with the two drivers, the sound of the ambulance can be heard nearby. I stood up and prepared myself for incoming help. As the ambulance parked, one familiar figure get out in a fresh white coat and her stethoscope. A flash of memories full of laughters running in my mind like a flash. Gosh, it was Denise! She was as shocked as me. Before I could say anything, a nurse came up and talked to her. It was a busy end. She looked back at me and just nodded, like telling me how we have a lot of things to catch up. She rode in an ambulance while I'm behind them driving my car. In the hospital, I waited for an hour before I could directly have a conversation with Denise. Hey Denise, you look amazing in your doctor's coat. I giggled so much to this. Hey Giselle, it is nice to meet you after a decade, she replied back. Jihan is also here. She's the head of our dentistry here in the hospital, Denise added. Wow! So I better catch up with her since I also need to go to a dentist, since I will be scheduled to go for another cruise. Denise then bid goodbye. I immediately looked Jihan and found her office along with a long line of patients. I did have a conversation with Jihan, and a successful checkup on my teeth was also done. It was indeed a blessed day to meet my longtime schoolmates. I then proceeded to my hot chocolate in Starbucks. Since it's almost lunch, I decided to stroll in a mall till 12 noon. When a loud scream in a crowd got my attention. Woohoo! Woo! Welcome everyone to a new fashion week with our very own pride Filipino designers, Clark!
muscle over me. I jumped through the crowd and found myself in the first line. My instincts were right. It was my bestie, Clark. I shouted, "Bestie! Bestie!" My joy can't be measured as I saw my bestie with his famous design and brands. I waved my hand as Clark saw me and ran to me. Bestie, I didn't know you have this brand. I have been wearing your designs for a long time. I greeted him with that news. I am glad for your support, Bestie. What about you? He asked. I am now a seafarer and I also own a crewing agency. Then the MC called Clark. I waved at him and decided to leave the I sighed joyously, reminiscing the days we had back then. A ring in the phone brought me back to reality. Hello? I answered. Hey Giselle, are you still near the hospital? Denise asked. Yes, Denise, I answered. I'd like to invite you for dinner at my house if it's okay, she asked, which I gladly replied, a big yes. Then, I remembered there was a grand opening of a resto inside the mall. So I checked its details on my phone and proceeded to the resto in the third floor. I went inside the resto and found an empty seat. A waiter went up to me and handed the menu. After I ordered, I stood up to check the paintings in the resto. As I took the time to understand the intricate paint man behind spoke. Such a lovely painting, right? I was startled and looked at the man. I stood there looking trance to the man behind me. Adam! I said after a long pause. So how's the designs? He asked, which I replied with a compliment. Let me take a guess. This is your resto, I asked, which Adam replied with a nod of pride. Our conversation ended up the moment my order was served. Food was such a delight. Fantastic! I proceeded my stroll in the mall until five of which reminded me that I was invited by Denise for dinner. I went to her address and found a mansion with a massive landscape. Whoa! I like the design of your house, Denise. Who designed this? I asked her. Well, this house was built by Patrick. He is now an engineer with Matt, who is business partner and an architect. Indeed, the news was a surprise. Do you have their company details? I might contact them for I'm planning to build my own house in Tagaytay. So our dinner went out and catching up our missed days and celebrations together. Sadly, I have to bid goodbye to Denise as I have a flight to catch up by midnight for my business in New York. For that expansion of my crewing company, and I already own 3 cruise ships, of which monitored by my COO and company lawyer, which is James! That's all my James! Before I boarded the plane, I dialed Sophia's number, asking for some updates on my ads regarding to my company. Oh, by the way, Sophia is my graphic artist and she owns her own firm. Fast forward, I am now sitting on my business class seat when I remembered my newly book entitled The Promise, which is written by Sharif. Sharif! New York's best-selling author and his works are recognized globally. It even won Nobel Prize in Literature. He is a criminal lawyer in New York and a true crime author. I read the book as the plane is boarding when a flight attendant approached my seat. Good morning, ma'am. What would you like for breakfast? She asked. While I called her by her name. It was Zeus. She is now a flight attendant of Philippine Airline and is starting to build her own vlogs for aspiring cabin crew. I landed in New York on time for my business meeting. Before I end this, to all of you, this prophecy of mine is not a telltale, but my hope.
If everyone is seated, On behalf of the Blessed Zion Academy of Cebu administration and teachers, I hope you accept the token of appreciation that they have carefully picked out for you. And keep in mind that they only have the best intentions for all of you, their beloved pupils. We also greatly appreciate the effort of all of you have put into your gowns and suits tonight, and evidently all the ladies look stunning in their gowns and the men dashing in their suits. So a round of applause for everyone who did a good job tonight dressing up here at our graduation ball and prom night. That has not been left unnoticed. So as we move on to the final part of our program, let me call onto the stage Mrs. Yunela Lavador. On stage for the awarding ceremony. So of course, because everyone is looking debonair tonight, we will be awarding the top and the best dressed ladies and gentlemen tonight. Tonight, we have the best dressed couple. Okay, so the best dressed male for tonight will be receiving a certificate and sash. So they are awarded best dressed during the JHS prom night and graduation ball given this 18th day of February 2023 at the Goldberry Hotel. So the best dressed male for tonight is Mr. Cyrus Munino. So Mr. Cyrus Munino, please come on stage to grab your certificate and your sash. Alright, now for the best dressed female, again the best dressed female for the night is Miss Micah Althea Chriselle Saga. Please come up on stage with your partner for your sash and certificate. So again, they are our best dressed couple for tonight. All right. Okay, congratulations to you guys. For anyone with violent reactions, you can take it up to your teachers. But they are our best dressed couple for tonight. All right, and a round of applause, please. All right. Now, our next award is the perfect match couple. Okay, so we have two couples who are the perfect match of the night. Now, our first pair, our first couple of the night, is Mr. Matmasal Nella and Miss Mary Ashley Villarreal. Please come up on stage, guys, to collect your certificate. Again, the first couple, the first perfect match couple of the night is Mr. Matt Nosal Nellis and Miss Ashley, Mary Ashley and Mary. So for this award, the The lady will be getting the sash while the gentleman will be getting the certificate. The perfect match couple. The first match, perfect match couple of the night. Leonel Jacob and Miss Jihan Katapusan. Please come up on stage, Mr. Liam and Miss Jihan Katapusan. You are our second perfect match couple of the night. So they are the sweetest and the perfect match couple for this evening. That is our perfect match award for tonight. They make our heads turn the second time around. So that is our head turner award for this evening. The male head turner awardee is Mr. John Patrick Papivo. While our female head turner awardee tonight is Michelle Tagalog. Our head turners that make us look a second time around.
Thank you.
stage, please go down first and then receive the ladies, okay? Alright, so for our next award tonight, we have the Star of the Night Award. So this is for the couple who has shown brightly like a star in the sky. So this is the Star of the Night. Our male Star of the Night awardee is Mr. Sharif Suwan. Accompanying him, the female Star of the Night is Miss Mary Ashley Villarreal. So they are both our Star of the Night couple tonight. Mary Ashley Villarreal on stage as our stars of the night. After this, we have four more awards to give out. So hold on to your seats, guys. We're not done with the awards yet. For this award, okay? These are the appreciation awardees. So we have an appreciation award for these ladies and gents for showing up tonight in their best form. So our first awardee is Mr. Stanley Clark Munier. Mr. Jonathan Fashona. Alright. And our last awardee for our appreciation award is Miss Sophia Fashona. Please come up on stage. Alright, guys. Don't forget to get the ladies from their tables, okay? And bring them up on stage. These certificates are to follow, so they will grab their certificate at the office later on during the school weekday. Alright, so your certificates, guys, are to follow. Grab them at the office on the latest school day. There are appreciation awardees of the night. Congratulations, guys. Again, another round of applause for all right, so the next awards that we will be giving out are our major awards for the night, okay? So our three major awards for tonight, we have the Queen and King of the Dance Floor, we have the Mr. and Miss Metamorphosis, and of course the King and Queen, the Prom King and Queen. Okay, so for our Queen of the Dance Floor and King of the Dance Floor, sorry, who do you think is the King of the Dance Floor tonight? Mr. John Dirk Fuentes. Mr. John Dirk Fuentes. And our queen
of the dance floor, of course, none other than Miss Denise Marie Cosmetic. All right, they are our king and queen on the dance floor. They have. All right, other side, guys. They have been the most graceful dancers tonight. They will be given a sash and a certificate as well. And our certificates to follow. All right, so take a picture for our king and queen of the dance floor. All right. Now our next major award is the Mr. and Miss Metamorphosis. Now this award goes to the couple who has shown up in their very best and has stunned and shocked everyone tonight with their transformation. So Mr. and Miss Metamorphosis. So our Mr. Metamorphosis for tonight is Mr. Adam James Hassan. And our Miss Metamorphosis for tonight is Miss Zushane Manuga. Congratulations. They have shocked us with their amazing transformation for this evening. Please come up on stage, Mr. Adam and Ms. Zushane. Alright, they will be receiving a sash as well for this award. Congratulations, guys. Who would have thought, with our transformation tonight? Yes. This is once in a while. All right, congratulations to our Mr. and Ms. Metamorphosis. All right, and now to our final award, our king and queen of the night, our prom king and queen. Who do you think is our prom king and queen? Recognition for so next time, guys, next year, as you you have to be very well dressed to grab the title of prom king and queen. So next, better luck next year for you, for you guys. But for tonight, we have Adam James Asylum and Estelle Tour for our prom. Given the chance to walk around the ball to showcase their crown. So again, for the rest of you guys, better luck next year. To be able to grab the prom king and queen title for next year, okay?
Yeah.
All right, now congratulations to all the awardees and to the rest of the group tonight. Now to mark the close of this program, let me call on Mrs. Leonila Lavador, our school administrator, for the closing remarks. Okay, good evening once again to everyone. I hope you aren't tired of looking at my face yet, as you have been seeing me all night tonight. I will keep this long, just that I would like to thank all the staff and teachers who have tirelessly worked on the decor and preparations for tonight, the first ever graduation ball and prom night would not have been a success without your efforts. Moreover, I would like to extend my heartfelt thanks to the pupils who have been shown up this evening. We hope that with the effort we have put into this event, you have truly enjoyed what we prepared. We also hope that we have genuinely made this night a night to remember for all of you.
Yes, sir, and I remember.
Thank you, and thank you. A night will spend. Enjoy the rest of the night and feel free to dance the night away.
And that is the end of the program, guys. Again, this was the first ever BZAC Graduation and Promenade Night 2023. Thank you for being here and celebrating with us tonight. You are all looking very beautiful and debonair. Enjoy the rest of the night as we have a social dancing hour where you can dance and party the rest of the evening until 10 o'clock. Okay? So again, we will put on some music for some social dance tonight. And you may also grab some more food at our buffet. For those who are still hungry, our buffet is still open till 10 tonight. So dance and enjoy the night away. Hey!
Hey! Thank you. Yeah! She's so wild, so animal. She's gonna work that sexy body, so sexual. She's like Be my fairy tale, make the ship set sail. You're the real love I've been hoping for. Be my fairy. mo tanan